It's Ash from Super Videos, back for another video for Season 9 of The Walking Dead. This is going to be my episode review for Season 9, Episode 2 of The Walking Dead, called The Bridge. So overall, I actually did enjoy this episode. It was a little slower paced than the first episode, I think. It might just be me, but I liked the first episode better than this episode. And that's not saying that this episode was bad. This is just a preference thing. I enjoyed the first episode a lot better, and maybe what also has something to do with my opinion is that Aaron's arm being chopped off, it was actually spoiled for me ahead of time, which obviously made me appreciate the episode a bit less. So maybe I'm biased in saying that I liked the first episode better. Anyway, let's jump right into this review. So starting off with the intro, we have a dialogue with Rick. The voiceover with Rick talking to Negan, and you know, we have the shots that are shown as a montage to show that they're rebuilding the bridge and everything, and basically showcasing that time has passed and all of that. Now, one small problem, I would have enjoyed that particular scene a bit more if they actually showed an interaction between Negan and Rick at that point. I know they kind of teased a little bit of it at the end of the episode, and of course they're gonna dive more into it later, but I think that it took away from the impact not showing it in this episode. So if they just spend a bit more time with Rick in the cell and maybe just show Negan, he doesn't have to say anything, but just show him react to what Rick is saying, that would have added a bit more to the episode. And maybe they wanted that to be a big reveal, who knows. And then going from there, I really also like the interaction between Ezekiel and Henry and Carol. I thought that was all great. The interaction between Carol and Henry specifically was very cool, seeing just how close those two characters have gotten together, and knowing the history between Carol and kids that get close to her also adds a bit more to that scene. And I absolutely love Ezekiel's conversation with Henry, saying that one day your grandchildren will walk through this bridge and you'll say that I built it. So I thought that was all great. I thought that was absolutely amazing. And then going from there, we of course see the construction of the bridge and see the camp nearby. I loved all of that. I think that they did that just right with the montage. They didn't need to stretch it out, and I feel like they definitely didn't stretch that part out, and they showed just enough to tell us what's been happening in the last 35 some days. So that was all great. And in the middle of all of this, they kind of have this story arc at the hilltop with Maggie talking to Michonne and Jesus about the situation at Hilltop, about Earl being in prison, about Gregory's recent assassination attempt and his execution. Now, I have mixed feelings about this. On one hand, I absolutely love what they're doing with Maggie and this moral decision about Earl, and you know, the fact that if they do let him out, he's gonna be a big help, but if they don't, then what's going to be the punishment for people who do certain things like that? So that was all great. And I love how Jesus was trying to be the voice of reason and trying to talk to Maggie and bring her up to speed about, you know, what's actually the right thing to do. Of course, as he says, he trusts Maggie, so he's not going to fully disagree with her and, you know, make a big deal out of it. But all of that I absolutely enjoyed. Obviously, the part with Maggie reacting to Tammy talking to Earl, all of that was phenomenal. The acting by the actress that plays Tammy, the actor that plays Earl, and Maggie herself, Lauren Cohan, it was absolutely amazing. It just grips you and you feel connected to the characters, even though you don't really know them. So all of that was great. My issue is them spoon-feeding the thing with Earl drinking too much and Herschel drinking too much. They just spoon-fed that to us. We get it. We're not dumb. We really do understand these things. So they don't need to spoon feed it to us and stretch it out. And I feel like they definitely did that. And just to add to that, the scene with Earl and Maggie, I feel like that was stretched out just a little bit. I felt a little bored watching that part of the episode. That's the only part of the entire episode where I felt like I just wanted to fast forward and just get it over with already. Aside from that, Michonne was a bit annoying in this episode. I feel like she was too much of a voice of reason in this episode, and it just got to a point that I was starting to get annoyed with Michonne in this episode. And then moving away from that, going back into the construction at the bridge, and of course, Henry giving everyone water, and of course, Justin pushing Henry because he didn't get enough water, and then the fight breaking out. I absolutely loved how that all came about. And I think that it was pretty amazing seeing Daryl stick up for Henry and actually talk about his emotions. So I absolutely enjoyed that. And I definitely do think that Justin is Jared number two. Jared was the asshole that we saw in season 7 and partially in season 8. And I think Justin is that point two. So that's another asshole of a savior that has to die. Probably will die soon. And then going from there, we have the herd attack and the savior letting go of the lumber. And of course, it drops on Aaron. Now, the thing with Aaron losing his hand, absolutely amazing. I really liked it. I love that they're remixing the story. They're giving the visual of Rick's comic book look to Aaron in the show. I absolutely love that. Now, one little problem that I had was the choreography of that scene was a bit off. But that's just a nitpick. Other than that, of course, as I've said before, this moment was spoiled for me before the episode aired. So I didn't really enjoy it as much as I could have if I didn't know already. But I absolutely loved that whole story arc. I really wanted Daryl to punch the other savior with the beard, because obviously he let go of the lumber. So as much as I wanted him to fight Justin, who was the initiator of that whole plan going wrong, but I also wanted him to, you know, fight this other dude, Mud, as well. I keep referring to him as the savior with the beard, but his name is Mud. So yeah, I really wanted Mud to get some of that beef from Daryl as well, but we didn't really see that. So that's another kind of problem that I had. Of course, we have Daryl showing up, finding out that Justin was the one that needed to distract the herd. He didn't do that. And he definitely goes at Justin. And I absolutely loved that Carol stops him. That was all great. Then we have the part with Rick and Justin. So, of course, Justin says something that pisses not only Rick off, but everyone. Then Rick's response was absolutely amazing. I really loved it. Specifically when he says, "If I see you again, stitches won't fix what I do to you." I think that was epic. That's my favorite Rick line in season 9 so far. That was absolutely epic. I really loved that whole entire scene. Not only this quote, but the entire scene that we saw between them. Then we get the Father Gabriel Anne part. Father Gabriel and Anne hitting it off. That's an odd couple that I didn't see them putting together or shipping, but it happened and it kind of works, to be honest. And just to say something that's connected to this, and seeing the helicopter, I'm starting to get a little irritated with the teases at the helicopter, because at this point we get it. The helicopter is a big deal. What is the deal with the helicopter? Just tell us already. So that's a little bit of me just whining a little bit. Going from there, the other things that I do want to touch on before we get to the final thing, which is the cliffhanger, is the savior is going missing. Maybe that's just savior's breaking apart from the sanctuary and trying to do their own thing, but maybe it's a tease at the whispers. Maybe the whispers have something to do with that. And for non-comic readers, whispers are just the next villains that are going to be introduced, and they're nothing like what you think. But I don't want to reveal too much. Two other things I have before we get to the cliffhanger. One is that moment between Ezekiel and Carol. I absolutely enjoyed that. I loved how Ezekiel was acting like a little boy at that point. So he was like very desperate to give this speech in front of everyone and to give the ring to Carol. So all of that was great. Of course, Carol said yes by not really saying yes, but I really enjoyed that moment. And then the last thing, Rosita and Arat. That moment between them when Rosita talks about how Arat put the cut on Rosita's face, I thought that was a great callback to something that happened in the previous seasons, and it just shows that those two characters have history between them. Absolutely love that. And at the end, of course, Justin getting knocked out or getting killed, most likely getting killed, we don't know. But who was it? I mean, it was someone he knew and it was someone that he liked. It wasn't like Daryl or Rick. Originally, I thought it was, but the tone that he had made it look like he was another savior. So I'm a believer that it was Mud who actually knocked him out or killed him. And I think he's going to kill him later on and try to frame Rick and the others in order to gain support from some of the saviors and to revolt against Rick and the other survivors. But that's just me. And I am doing a standalone video on that. And the video I'm doing about this is kind of connected to something else I found recently. Potential spoiler. So stay tuned for that right after this. Maybe an hour after this. But that's basically it for my review of the episode. It was a good episode. It was a very solid episode. I enjoyed the first episode more than this episode. But this episode was still a pretty good episode. That's it for this video. See you next time for another super video. If you like what you see, press like, subscribe for more content, and press the bell button to receive notifications for daily uploads. Like and follow the Facebook page of this channel to join our community, and check out the upload schedule to learn more about daily uploads.